Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Those who are new, welcome to my channel. Last video we have learned about the types and meaning of resources. After that we see scarcity of resources and what are the causes of scarcity of resources. In today's class let us see a conservation of resources. The rapid increase in resources use and their degradation result in the serious problem to the mankind. The rapid changes or rapid increasing in the use of resources, it is the degradation result, it is a main and a serious problem to the mankind or human beings. We may not get a pure water to drink, clean air to breathe. Many resources may be exhausted and biodiversity may decline and earth itself may become the waste dump. Here we see that we did not have a clean air to breathe, we did not have a clean water to drink and we did not have any clean resources to use in our daily life. On that cause the biodiversity may be declined in the area of our earth and our earth became a waste dump. How they address this issue? So it can be done through the conservation of resources. It would make better through the conservation of resources. Now let us move on. The conservation of natural resources means not to waste them but they use them judiciously and so that it is a balance between nature and our in natural resources or uses in the natural resources. Here we see that the conservation means natural resources. Conservation means the waste of many natural resources. Without wasting of those resources, we have to use a balance between nature and our resources. The natural resources. So the conservation has been defined as the management of a biosphere for the benefit of the life, including a humankind, so that it may yield the sustainable benefit to the present generation while the maintaining its potential to meet the needs and aspirations of the future generation. We have to conserve our resources to upcoming our next generation and we have to protect our resources. Now let us move on. The conservation of resources is in the responsibility of all of us. The conservation of resources is a responsibility of all of us. How can we do it? It is a main question related to this. How can we do this? We can do this adopting the 4R strategy like reduce, reuse, recharge and regenerate and research. It is a 4R. Those are reduce, reuse, recharge, regenerate and another one is research. Let us understand in a short meaning. Now let us see one by one. Now first one is reduce. Reduce refers to the minimizing the use of resources and their wastage and are trying to use less amount of any resources. It will also reduce the pollution. For example, you can reduce air pollution by reducing the use of your vehicles. Here we see that the reduce refers to the minimizing of our use of resources. We have to try our resources to use a less amount of those resources. It will also reduce the pollution in our environment. For example, it is a best example related to this. We can reduce air pollution by reducing the use of vehicles. So while we using our vehicle on that time, our vehicle are remove some dirty airs through that and it will create air pollution. Now those are all about the reduce. Now let us reuse. This is a very simple but effective way to conserve the resources. Every resources has not only the alternative use but it can be used multiple times. Here we see that it is a very simple and effective way to conserve the resources, protect the resources. And here we see every resources has not only the alternative use, but it can uses for multiple times, many times. For example, here is one example is there. Now let us see. The water that we use that
for bathing,
it can be used for great gardening waste paper. It can be converted into packaging material. Here we see that it is a best example. The water we use in the bathing, it can be reused as in their our garden. We can water those plants, and waste paper can use or it can converted into packaging material. These are all about reuse. Now let us see recharge and regenerate. This refers to the taking a step to allow the resources to grow through the conscious human effort. All rainwater harvesting affected the recharge ground and groundwater. Afforestation recharge trees and stock the biodiversity. Those are all about the recharge and regenerate. Here in this area we see that it refers to the taking a step to allow the resources to grow through the conscious human effort. It is grow through the human effort. All rainwater harvesting effort, it change, it recharge groundwater and afforestation recharge trees and stock into biodiversity. Now let us move on research. Researching way to find a renewable and alternative to non-renewable resources, the solar or wind energy, it is a renewable and alternative to the energy we use. Here we see that research means researching way to find renewable resources, renewable alternative to non-renewable resources like solar, wind energy and renewable alternative like energy we use in our daily life. Now let us see, here are some checklist, some things we can do to conserve the resources. Now let us see one by one. We purchase less stuff, use items as long as you can and ask yourself if you really needed something new. Here we see that we use a particular thing. Our second one is reduce exercise packaging, for example drinking water for the tap, and instead of buying it in a plastic bottle. Well, on that time we have to reduce the exercise of packaging the drinking water from the tap and instead of buying in a plastic bottle. Now let us see, recycle material like metal cans, old cells, phones and plastic bottles. Here we see that we should recycle the materials like metal cans, old cell phones and plastic bottles. We can recycle this and purchases a product made by the recycled material. Next, keep air and water clean by not polluting the environment. The plant new trees and replace one and we cut down. We have to plant a new trees where we cut the trees. Drive lesser and take public transport, bicycle or walk. Here we see that everyone has their own motorcycle or own car. They think those vehicles are shows their economical position in the society, but innerly it will affect that human being. On that cause we have to take public transportation like bus, train, those kind of things we have to use in our public transport, or we use bicycle or walk. Now let us see, the conserve energy at a home and turning off light when not needed. We have to switch off our light or our fan when we did not need that. The conservation aspects has been realized to all the countries which have adopted the principle of sustainable development that seeks to achieve the development in such a manner that is a resources and the environmental quality are conserved for the use for a future generation. We have to conserve the energy and resources for our upcoming or future generation. We don't use our natural resources or any kind of resources unnecessarily. It is our responsibility to secure our resources to our upcoming generations. In today's class, we have learned about the conservation of resources. In that area, we see reduce, reuse, recharge and regeneration. After that, we see the research. After that, we see some checklist related to the conservation, how to conserve the resources. If you have any queries regarding this, comment below. Thank you for watching this.